all fucking day and night. You can text, text, text. You know why, lady? Us men want to communicate with you, but they don't want to fucking talk to you. If a man can get you out your house, across town, and in his bed, and never hear your fucking voice, that is a fucking Christmas present every day for a fucking man. See? Look at these motherfuckers.
Men don't like when women talk, so trying to navigate a world where men want you to shut up and girls learn that girls should shut up. So you've got to find a way to make people who don't like the tone of your voice or your pitch to listen. If you talk about girl shit, it's not funny, you know? Like, men talk about their dicks all the time, but if you talk about your pussy or your period or dating or, you know, feeling insecure about your body, now it's a girly bit. And when insecurity is a universal experience.
Yes, that's a lot of moving. I'm on my period, so I can't be shaking it up and down. I got a fat pad. You know, they got fat pads now for fat bitches. This is what happens. They want it to be a war between skinny bitches and fat bitches over pads. The fat pad is so different than the skinny pad because the skinny pad for the skinny bitches has integrity. It's in a little purple box, and it's got always written in calligraphy. And the commercial, the bitch is like, always. And you're like, what, bitch? You got what? Oh, shh. I'm bleeding. And then the fat pad is called Forever, and it's in a big black box with chains. And it's three dudes in the commercial beatboxing, pads. Then the fat bitch comes out through the smoke. Hey, I'm on my period. Ah, I'm bleeding to death.
And then you add blackness on top of it. You have people, black people even have told me this. Don't talk about race too much. You want to alienate the audience. And it's like, well, that's, I guess, 95% of my experience race. So you're asking me to not be an authentic human so as to please. So you're basically asking me to do white dude comedy and I'm not a white dude. So it's not gonna work. It took a while, but I got to the point where I'm gonna talk about race because I feel like it. I was talking to this like white guy and there's this thing that happens with white guys where they don't know black women are people. So they say the weirdest things to you. Like this dude, he was like, hey, I'm hot, you're hot. Let's make beautiful interracial babies together. I know. I looked at him and I was like, nah. Not because I'm against interracial dating. Please have a marble swirl cake party. That's good for you. But he said beautiful interracial babies. And I'm shallow and I'm petty. So why would I purposely get with you to make a person hotter than me? Why would I do that? That's ridiculous. Because home's supposed to be a sanctuary. So how is mommy supposed to love herself when there's some Lisa Bonet, Halle Berry looking ass kid sitting on my couch watching SpongeBob with her pretty green eyes? No! Get the fuck out of here.
I'm sure a lot of female comics have crazy stories of comics hitting on them. I remember one time I was on the road. I bombed. I bombed really badly that night. And the headliner, he called me. He was just like, how you doing? And I was just like, oh, I'm feeling down. And he was just like, oh, why don't you come over to my room? Now, in hindsight, I'm listening to them just like, well, this sounds like some bullshit or a setup. But I just bombed. Like, I bombed for like 20 minutes straight. I'm feeling down. This guy seemed nice enough. And he's just like, oh, come through. I didn't want to sit there by myself. So I was like, all right. So I came in and dude answered the door naked. I mean, so it's like shit like that happens. You're just like, what the fuck is going on here? So at that point, I'm just like, well, I guess I'm gonna have to be sad by myself in my room because he's clearly let me know that he's offered me dick. I don't think he just accidentally got out the shower and didn't have a chance to put clothes on.
A lot of times you hear black male comics talk about black women because that's the first thing that they can, you know, touch. And it's sometimes it's disparaging. You know, it's always the, and you know, my girlfriend, and she, you know, and it's like, not every, all you motherfuckers is dating the same hood-ass bitch. And then half the time you see them, and it's like, you're given this experience of a black woman, but you're not even with a black woman. So that can be frustrating. Comedy is important. People take that shit seriously, you know? And if that's the way you're presenting black women, that's why we're having a lot of the problems we have. And I can say that for black women as well, how they represent black men. It's not every time you talk about black people, we broke, we poor, we ignorant, we don't know what's going on. You can go further than that for a joke.